gap. So without actually looking at the, opening it out and seeing what the problem is, they thought by putting in one more length of pipe, which is the standard response, they might, if the rate of the flow into the borewell is less, they can compensate for it, and they're trying to control the output valve and so on. I think yesterday, when your people came and looked at it, they realized that when they're pumping, there is no variation in the water level.
We observe variation.
But I think
we do the pump test on this borewell.
Okay.
So we have measured the discharge, but there is a gap in after you, as you said.
Yeah.
After
yeah.
40 or 45 minutes, seconds.
Seconds.
That gap also we observed.
But did the level itself vary in the borewell? Manjunath, my manager was saying.
Level doesn't vary, but the discharge
so he was thinking
is not
maybe
constant.
It might be due to the motor or some other issue. They thought the water level itself is dropping, so it's pumping air, and then again the water level is building up. That was their guess, which doesn't look like that is the case.
So why does that happen, Dhananjay? Why does intermittent discharge usually come in borewells?
I think it depends on the pump capacity, or maybe in problem.
So it's a pumping problem.
Pumping
it's not
problem.
It's not some characteristic of the aquifer or the pressure variations in the aquifer.
No. Generally not.
Generally not.
We had the same problem in the other borewell. And when we investigated, when they took out the pipes, they said some of the pipes have gaps and rusted, holes in them. So all the pumping pressure was getting eased off.
Okay.
So the threading wasn't, threading had to be redone. So we replaced a few pipes and
These then are issues where we are saying that the maintenance of the borewell somewhere has been compromised.
Yeah. No periodic monitoring or maintenance.
So somewhere we really don't understand the real costs of borewell maintenance.
Not at all. As long as they yield, we continue to assume it is free.
Okay, Dhananjay, just a quick set of questions. So now you are doing a well inventory, right? This is what you are doing. So you will go to every borewell or every well in a generic sense and speak to the local people to try and find maximum information about the well, which can help you understand the aquifers better. So typically, what is this information? Quickly, without getting into too many technical details, what are the kind of information you capture?
Okay, first we know when the borewell borewell or dugwell is set up in that area. Second, the depth of that well or dugwell. Third is at what level water will struck.
Okay.
Then what is the lithology of that well?
Can you briefly explain what lithology is? Not everybody understands what lithology is.
Okay. What is the time interval of that? Means say a soil, then hard rock, then again blackish or whitish rock types.
Right.
And what is the grain size of that material which came out during the borewell?
Got it. So it's more like as you dig how the earth looks.
Yeah.
What the nature of earth is.
Yeah.
So these are the four things.
Yeah.
Anything else? Primarily these four.
Primarily these four.
So the depth of when it was dug, the depth of the well, at what height depth it yielded water, and what did the earth look as we dug. These are the four things you look at.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Dhananjay. You're from Aquadam.
Yeah.
Control one is real video.